probably one of the finest mat technicians in the world, but this is all the ordinary competitor.
Hi, Big Bad John is indeed that big fella. And he does not appear to be overly impressed with Ricky the Dragon.
Well, he's definitely dwarfing Ricky the Dragon. Look at the size of this guy.
Well, there's an old saying, of course, it's not so much the size of the man in the fight as it is the size of the fight in the man, so...
I'll tell you one thing it is for sure, and that's the science, and that's one department it's awfully hard to outdo the Dragon in. This guy knows the leverage, he knows the moves, he has endurance. International reputation precedes this guy, but don't go head-on with Big Bad John.
Well, he tried it, and that didn't work at all.
Tremendous amount of power right there. You've seen him run right into him, knocked him right on his can right there. WCW Pro, Bash at the Beach, his owner's gotten soul. It's going to be on fire right here. Go behind. Roseanne Barr, Dreamhead's calling in from all over the world. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat has a headlock.
Side headlock working on Big Bad John. Big Bad John brings his man up. And brother, dumped him across the ring. So obviously, Ricky is not going to be able to go after this man strength for strength. He's going to have to rely on that speed, his dexterity, and his wrestling skills. And that's exactly what he did just then. Good chain reaction on that one as he got around and behind his man, takedown, keeps the side headlock on the Big Bad John.
Yeah, he'd be well off to keep Big Bad John on the mat also. You see Steamboat take him down. Hard to keep a, you know, a big man like this down, but you've got to try because you don't want him moving around like
this. Oh. Big drop kick right there. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, who had used that headlock unsuccessfully. Big Bad John, bigger man, stronger man right here going back to it. If I was Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and analyzing this match, I would not use the headlock. I would be fine on him, drop kicking him, taking him down. Crossbody and trying to beat him. That's my analysis of this thing so far.
Well, I would certainly have to agree with you there. He'd be very wise to go to the legs, take him off his feet. Everybody's basically the same size when they're stretched out on the canvas.
You know, let me coincide with Dusty's analysis of that. Steamboat also, I think, has to get vicious. He's just too nice of a guy, and he has to get more vicious. Big Bad John is...
Power slam by Big Bad John brings his man down. Oh. Tried for a pinning combination. Ricky the Dragon slid away from that one, however.
You know, Big Bad John seems to be taking to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Big Bad John has a tremendous amount of size and power we all have talked about right here. This is an opportunity for Big Bad John to, the whole world is watching, to take a win, go to the pay window on Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Yeah, definitely a reputation here of Steamboat as a feather in anybody's cap. Bam! Right smack in the choppers.
Catches him once again, and this is a critical match for Ricky the Dragon because he's got a U.S. Heavyweight Championship match coming up with stunning Steve Austin at Blast at the Beach, and I'll tell you what, he needs this victory very, very badly.
Well, the whole world is looking forward to Bash at the Beach right here. He does need a victory. Over this man, you know, Stunning Steve Austin is a different type of competitor than Big Bad John. Stunning Steve Austin is more of a wrestler, can get down and go with you, can also brawl with you. I think Ricky the Dragon Steamboat right here, the test that he's really facing him at this point in time is trying to counteract the power of this Big Bad John. You see that big knee right in his old belly welly right there, got him reeling and rocking, rolling to the break of dawn. Bash at the Beach, Hogan and Flair, I got my ticket.
I hear that. He presses it way over his head, dumps it across the ring.
Pressed him. He just used Steamboat for a dumbbell.
Crash down across him with that elbow, hooks the far leg, tries for the pinfall. Ricky the Dragon rolls a shoulder off, however.
Boy, Steamboat may not make it to the Bash at the Beach here. This guy's big. There's a lot of weight coming off of there.
Watch out for the Dragon, and he's in trouble here as he rolls to one side. And the Dragon finally beginning to explode temper-wise. Closes in, puts the boots to him, catches him with a hard right hand, another hard right hand. And it's Big Bad John jammed into the turnbuckle. Ricky the Dragon now beginning to unload some heavy artillery on Big Bad John.
Yeah, Steamboat's making his move. You can watch the mouth of Big Bad John. He's starting to suck air. He's a big man. He may have run out of gas here. And Steamboat, of course, just a ton of endurance. He's making his move. See if it's good enough.
All right, Irish with Big Bad John charges in with a fist, but Ricky the Dragon slipped away, a will-o'-the-wisp, if you will. Now he's going up on that top rope. Let's see what happens here as Ricky the Dragon hurdles off the top rope, cross body block, gets the pinfall. Fantastic pinfall for Ricky the Dragon as he came flying from that top rope, caught his man high on the shoulders, drove him down to the mat for the pin. And he's got stunning Steve Austin on his mind.
You know, guys, it's only Big Bad John made two mistakes in this situation right here. You've seen him miss that high wrist maneuver from the top. Also, in a reverse one to the turnbuckle, he missed that shot right here. Ring of the Dragon, Steamboat, flying like an eagle across, hooks the leg, one, two, three, pay one at a time. Stunning Steve Austin, Steamboat, bash at the beach.